measuring of Quran.
No.
How much did I say?
You have to literally.
That's what I'm trying to say.
But doesn't count.
My heart. No, it counts because my heart might be greedy. My heart might say that I want to give £10, but Allah requires me to give more. His standards is that I give more money, but my heart only wants to give £10. But in my mind, because I gave £10, I will feel that I've done a good deed, right? Yeah. Other people will say, oh, she did a good deed, but Allah is not happy because Allah wants more. So how do I know how much Allah wants from me? That's what I'm trying to ask.
Okay. There is type of charity. There's different type of charity. There's type of charity. God can bless you with it. They call zakah. Example, like you go like £1 million, I give you. Yeah? God, you got percentage from that £1 million, God could present it to give you charity. If you don't have a £1 million, example, you got £1,000 in your pocket. Yeah? So if you go to the road, you can give you 1p or 20p or 1 pound to the people. That's a different charity. That's God doesn't require it to you. You have to give you more to bless God. No.
So how much?
Only certain money to give to bless God.
Well, how much? Which one?
The one I'm telling you, the £1 million.
How much?
We give you £1 million.
He says to give £1 million, Allah.
No, if you got £1 million.
Yes.
From that £1 million, 20%. Or 25% from that £1 million, that is a charity for God. You must give it. If you don't give it, yeah, that's you disobey Allah.
But if I did give,
you disobey.
If I gave, is that good deed?
If you give in, what Allah required, to how much percent from this £1 million given, yeah, it's a good
deed. It's a good deed. What if in my heart I'm not happy to give?
If you're not happy to give, even you give in, yeah, you're not happy to give him, but if you give in, God doesn't write for you is a good word.
No, but how do you know that? This is
because I know it's God mentioned it.
You don't know his moral standard. How do you know
but
that?
God mentioned it.
Because you keep doing the good deeds, but you don't know where to end.
You keep doing the good deeds and you're not happy.
Can I say something? Yeah. So the conversation is basically salvation in both faiths, is that right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so do you believe that according... Sorry to interrupt.
No, please.
Do you believe that according to Islam, salvation is quite straightforward? It's quite clear cut and it's kind of like you do this, that and the other and then you are saved, yes?
Yeah.
Okay, can I read to you from the Quran? Okay. Because when I read the Quran, all due respect, when I read the Bible, I see the Bible has a very clear message of salvation. It's quite consistent, okay?
Yeah.
When I read the Quran, if I was a Muslim, I'd be concerned for my salvation because there are certain things that will leave you confused. For example, contradictory statements about salvation. Okay?
In Quran or in Bible?
In Quran. Okay. So in the Bible, I say it's quite straightforward. In the Quran, it's kind of muddy. Okay, and you can't really tell if you're going to be forgiven or not. Let me explain why. In Surah 4, verse 48, it says, indeed, Allah does not forgive association with him. That's shirk, yes? Mm-hmm. So Allah says the sin of shirk will not be forgiven, yes?
Yeah.
Okay.
Whatever did you did it, will not forgiven.
Okay, will not be forgiven. Okay. Yeah. That's what it says. It says shirk will not be forgiven. Okay?
Shirk meaning you worshipping
something
without him.
Worshipping something other than Allah is shirk and it won't be forgiven.
Yeah, well,
so do you agree with that?
Even you give all your house.
That's fine. Allah, okay, so whatever you do, it cannot be forgiven. Okay?
Yeah.
And it actually reiterates this later on in the same chapter. It says Allah forgives not that partnership be set up with him, okay? He forgives anything else, okay? But that he doesn't forgive, all right? But then there's a problem because that what I've just read there is two separate verses in the same chapter, okay? This is the third verse in the very same chapter that contradicts what I've just told you, okay? And let me explain why this makes sense, doesn't make sense for your point of view. It does make sense with my point of view, the way I look at Muhammad, okay? So in the same chapter 4, verse 153, it says, the people of the scripture ask you to bring down to them a book from heaven, but they had asked of Moses even greater than that and said, show us Allah outright. Okay? So the thunderbolt struck them for their wrongdoing. Then they took the calf for worship. So they worship something other than Allah, which cannot be forgiven.
Yeah.
Okay? It cannot be forgiven, can it?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, it cannot be forgiven. The problem is, this very verse says, and we pardoned that. So in one passage, in two places in the same chapter of the Quran, it says shirk will not be forgiven, okay?
Mm.
And then later on in the very same chapter, it says shirk will be forgiven. So I'm asking you this here, and this is the way I look at this, okay? If this is from God, there should be no contradiction like this, especially in terms of salvation, okay? But if this is coming from the mind of a man who's having this revelation given to him bit by bit by bit, it would make perfect sense that at some point he's going to contradict himself, Okay? Now, it's not only there that does this. Let me just finish my point. In chapter 2, it says that the Jews, the Christians and the Sabians, they don't have anything to worry about on the last day. Okay? But then in the very next chapter, it says, if anyone desires a religion other than Islam, it will never be accepted. So according to your own Quran, in the same chapter, a certain sin will not be forgiven. Then that same sin is forgiven, okay? And then you have Jews, Christians and Sabians having absolutely nothing to worry about. And then the next chapter contradicts that. So I'm putting forward to you that this makes sense if it comes from the mind of a man, not from the mind of God. Okay. I'll hand it over to you.
Okay. First of all, Allah doesn't forgive anyone worship other than Him.
According to that?
Yeah, doesn't forgive him. Allah doesn't forgive anyone worship something else rather than Him. That's one thing. If you worship one God, doesn't have a son, doesn't have a brother, doesn't have a whatever daughter, whatever it is, doesn't dream, doesn't sleep, worship one, He's a creator, He's created everything under Him, and you believe that on your heart, and you pray what He said to pray for Him.
I understand.
Whatever you did it, God forgive you.
So even though...
One minute. Whatever you did, if you kill someone.
Yeah, okay.
If you kill someone, you're robbing, you do a lot of bad things, you sell drugs, whatever you did it, God will forgive you when you come repent it to Him. Okay. When you repent, you tell Him that you repent it to Him, and God, please forgive me what I done it.
Okay.
But Satan made me to do it. That's God forgive me.
Okay,
that's
so one I think you...
One minute. And the second one, you know Moses. Moses, he killed someone.
Yes.
He killed someone from... You kill someone.
Yeah, can I interject?
He ran away.
Okay, let me interject.
One minute. He ran away. After when he ran away, he got making perfect, right?
Okay.
So, he believed that God is one. Because if he doesn't believe that God is one, God is never going to forgive
him. Okay, then let me stop you there. Okay? Yes. So, I agree with what you're saying. That, you know, it does say... You can stay. Okay. Okay. So, I agree it does say, okay, that some sins, that sin won't be forgiven. You said that yourself, that shirk won't be forgiven, okay?
Yeah.
So then how do you explain shirk being forgiven in chapter 4, 153? How do you explain that same sin being forgiven?
Okay, shirk forgiven, that's meaning when you left the shirk and you come back to God.
But the previous verse
is... That's what it says.
The previous verse, it says shirk won't be forgiven. It says...
The second one is shirk forgiven.
It says...
What is the condition of the shirk forgiven?
It says any other sin will be forgiven.
So what is it? What is
But what
does the chapter say?
So let me just ask you this, okay? So you don't see that there's a contradiction when in two passages in the Quran... two passages in the Quran say it will be forgiven, but the one passage in the same chapter says it won't... Two places in the Quran it says it won't be forgiven. Then two places says in one place it says it will be forgiven. You don't see a contradiction there. And let me explain to you why I think that the Islamic concept of God also, in terms of justice and mercy, is not from God. Let me explain to you why. For one, because we see contradictory statements in terms of salvation. So I would say, how can you trust a book that speaks about salvation when it contradicts itself about salvation? Okay. But let me give you the Christian concept. Okay. We believe that God is both just and merciful. Okay. So if God is both just and merciful, God will have to punish sin. He will have to deal with sin. Okay. But if God is also merciful, He will want to show His mercy. Okay. Now I would say in the Islamic concept of God, all due respect, okay, in the Islamic concept of God, you can't say God is both just and merciful. You can say He's merciful because He just forgives sin, but we've just established His forgiveness is actually arbitrary. Sometimes He forgives a sin, sometimes He doesn't, okay? But I would say you cannot say He's just and merciful, because simply sweeping sin under the rug and not dealing with it is not at all just, okay? Because let me put to you like this. Let's say I've committed loads of crimes, and God forbid, I end up in a courtroom, okay? And the judge says to me, Mr. Bill, Ben, you've done this, you've committed these crimes, I'm going to punish you. And I say, judge, I know I've committed these crimes, okay, I'm sorry, and I'm never going to do it again. Imagine if the judge turns around and says to me, Ben, that's fine, I accept that, leave, you're fine to go. That judge would be unjust, because he's not fulfilling his role as a judge in condemning sin, okay? Now I would say in Islam, that's your judge. You have a judge that doesn't fully deal with sin. My judge is this, okay? Let's imagine we're in that same courtroom, okay? And I'm standing before the judge. And I say to the judge, I'm very sorry for my sin. you know, this, that and the other, and the judge says, Ben, you stand condemned. Now let's imagine someone bursts through the courtroom doors, they kick open the doors, and they say, judge, I will pay this man's fine on behalf of him because I love him. The judge can legally set me free, okay, because somebody else has paid my fine in my place. But even with that analogy, it doesn't go far enough, because that same individual also would have sins in the eyes of God. So his sin would also need to be paid for, okay? Now let's imagine the judge himself, because my presupposition is Jesus is God, and the Bible says that all will stand before the judgment seat of Christ, okay? Now let's imagine I'm still standing before that same judge. But instead of somebody bursting open the courtroom door and paying my fine for me, let's imagine the very judge himself stands up, puts down the hammer, takes off his judge's robe and says, I will pay for your sin because I love you. Okay, that's what we say Jesus done. So we say in Jesus, on the cross, is where God's justice and mercy meet without any contradiction or without any overlap. Because at the cross, in Christ, God dealt with sin. Okay? But also at Christ, on the cross, we can obtain mercy by looking to what was done on the cross and receiving Christ as Saviour. So at the cross is where two of these attributes that would contradict in Islam, they do not contradict in Christianity. Hand over to you.
Okay. There's one thing. Example, you gave it to me for the court, whatever, is going to forgive you or not. You can't not compare court, yeah, judging and forgiving you and God.
Is God a judge?
God judge, there's two different things.
But is God a judge?
But you made a mistake.
Go ahead.
You made a mistake, God. The judge is forgive you. But how about the family? How about the family? You kill someone, okay. How about the family? Family won't forgive you. The judge, he can forgive you. But the family never gonna forgive you. So if the family doesn't forgive you, no matter judge forgiving you, God won't accept it. God doesn't accept it. Only one condition can God accept it for judge forgiving you, yeah? And the family accept it. Yeah? That's only God can forgive you.
Okay, so
but God forgive you, but the family doesn't forgive you.
Okay.
That doesn't mean that you will forgive him.
Okay, so if you commit a crime against let's say you have a fight with your neighbour, you hit him, he dies, okay? If for example you ask God to forgive you, but the family doesn't forgive you, will God forgive you?
If the family doesn't forgive you,
will God then forgive you?
Of course.
Using your own analogy.
Okay, of course. Because
okay, so if of course...
1 minute.
No, 1 second. Because if God will forgive you, regardless of the forgiveness of the family,
but 1 minute,
then my courtroom analogy
depends.
Is perfectly fine.
Okay, no. Because everything is up to God. You have to come from the first and then you have to come down. Because from Prime Minister, you have to come to the MP, right? So, example. Let me give you an example. You kill or you punch someone. Like Moses did it, he killed someone. Because the way he believed in God, yeah, he killed someone and ran away. He worshiped one God, doesn't associate with any other thing. Only worship one God. He asked forgiveness for God, and then God forgive him. So who created the person is a God. Right? Who is the punishing?
I don't think I'm following you, sorry. Because let me reiterate.
Okay, example. Okay, the family. Okay, the family doesn't forgive you.
One second. Right, we are talking, okay, about God. We're not talking about the family who the sin may have been committed against. We're talking about God as a judge, because we both agree God is the judge of the universe, yes?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
No, one second. Okay.
I'm making sure to
No, let me just reiterate, okay?
Yeah.
So if God is the judge, we both agree God is the judge of the universe. God judges the living and the dead, yes? So if God judges, okay, what I'm saying is this. These two attributes that contradict each other in Islam, they do not contradict each other in Christianity, because they are both kept at the cross. God's justice and mercy are both shown at the cross. In Islam, you don't have that. You have an arbitrary God who sometimes forgives sins, sometimes doesn't forgive sins, ultimately doesn't make forgiveness clear, because like I've showed you earlier, shirk won't be forgiven, then actually is forgiven. Christians, Jews and Sabians have nothing to worry about.
What is saying in the verb saying that God could forgive and shirk?
He won't forgive it.
What is it saying? Okay. He's saying shirk.
Okay. Surah 4, I'll read it one more time for you, okay?
He said doesn't give shirk, forgiving.
Surah 4,
yeah.
48. Indeed, Allah does not forgive association with him.
That's it.
So he doesn't forgive it.
He doesn't forgive any shirk.
Okay, so he doesn't forgive So shirk is worshipping something other than Allah, yes?
That's it, yeah.
Okay, so, okay. So then why does he forgive it in Surah 4153?
What is giving? What does
okay, they worship,
giving shirk.
They worship the golden calf. They
giving shirk.
They're worshipping something other than Allah, which is shirk. But then it says, and we forgave that.
Okay, did they repent it or not?
Hold on. It doesn't matter if they repented.
No,
because
it doesn't matter.
The verses before says it won't be forgiven.
No.
If you actually read Surah 4, verse 84, okay, it says he forgives anything else, but not that.
Okay. But this one, because you're cutting it now. Because you're cutting it, the verse.
Would you like to read the whole thing?
No, you're cutting the verse now. Because the verse forgiven for shirk, how God is going to give them for shirk like this? Example, somebody worship three. Huh? God is going to forgive him. Shirk.
Okay, let me ask you this.
1 minute. He's not going to give you for shirk. This is shirk. He's not going to forgive him. So how are you telling me God is some one place saying forgiving for shirk and one place is telling me that, doesn't give
that's shirk what
for
I'm
shirk.
Asking you. 1 minute. That's what but I'm asking you to answer. But that's what your Quran says. It's not me stating it. Your Quran says that.
Okay, my Quran, the way he's saying is something missing because if it's true, okay. Quran.
Do you have a Quran on you?
Listen to me. If you are, because you're telling me Quran saying it. That's not true. What
so
that's, are you saying?
So what I'm reading is
no.
So that's a fake Quran.
No, because I don't know if it's a Quran or not. Because I didn't see
okay,
the Quran
okay.
or not.
We can solve this. Because do you have a Quran on you right now?
Listen to me. I don't have a Quran with me.
Do you have a phone?
Listen to me. But God is forgiving for shirk, society. You know shirk, yeah, forgiving. And one is doesn't forgive. One is doesn't forgive is God is shirk, meaning you keep worshipping something else with God, and until you die, God never gonna forgive.
Does the verse say
that's
that?
One,
does
one,
the verse
one,
say
that's
that?
One.
Does the verse say
okay,
that?
Okay, that's one condition. The second one, he's saying forgiving. There's somebody keep worshipping tree or car, whatever it is, and he realized that he's doing something wrong, and he come back to God, and he repented. Huh? And he repented. When he repented, 1 minute, when he repented from yeah, what he's doing, when he worshipping something else rather than God, he come back to God and he asked for God, please forgive me. I did something big mistake. I worship something else rather than you. Please forgive me. That's forgiven.
But can you?
But if he didn't say that and he keep worshiping something else, God doesn't forgive. What is it? What
okay,
did he say?
But can you
read it for me?
Can you show me that in the Quran?
Read it for me.
Okay, I've read it to you twice.
No. Okay. Because I'm not talking about doesn't forgive for shirk one. I'm talking about giving. Give him for shirk one, show me.
No. See, what you're doing is you're moving. Now, let me finish. You're moving the goalpost. You're saying, don't give me the one where he does forgive it. Give me the one where he doesn't forgive it. Okay? And I'm saying, no, they go, they're in the very same chapter.
But I explained
one
to
second.
You already.
They are in the same surah.
But I explained
one,
to you
already. One second. If your message from the Quran is a clear cut message about salvation, then we shouldn't find such contradictions like that. If, for example, okay, let me say this to you, okay? If I said to you, if you punch me in the face, yeah, 1 second. If you punch me in the face, I'm never going to forgive you, okay? And then you punch me in the face and then I forgive you. Have I contradicted myself? I have. Okay, yeah. Okay. So you agree I've contradicted myself. So why is it a contradiction when I say it, but when the Quran does that, that's no longer a contradiction?
No, Quran doesn't say that.
It doesn't, okay. It
doesn't say that.
Okay, then you're not going to trust my reading of the Quran.
No.
I encourage you, pull out your phone
yeah.
and look up the Quran passages yourself and you can read them to the camera right now.
I don't have it now. But I can bring Quran from any Muslim person, yeah? I can bring any Quran. Rather, it's a simple thing.
Okay, how about this? We go on Google, Quran, yes?
No, listen to this. Let me explain to you one condition first.
So now you don't want to go to the Quran?
No, go to the Quran. I don't mind. Go to the Quran. But I want to explain to you that the shirk, the one forgiven, yeah? Is he keep doing the shirk until he die?
But it doesn't say that.
Is he saying that?
Does it say that?
Okay, if it doesn't say that, it doesn't forgive. So that's
okay.
English, no.
If he doesn't say that, he doesn't forgive, but he does forgive. You're contradicting the Quran.
I'm not contradicting the Quran. I already explained to you.
You're saying.
I'm not contradicting the Quran. I already tell you the clear.
You're
because if
me.
You worship one God, yeah, rather than anything else, anything you do, you repent to God, God forgive you. But
okay.
If you worship something else,
okay.
Whatever you do, whatever you repent, yeah, or whatever you do, God doesn't forgive you.
Okay.
Unless you repent, you come back to him.
Okay, so in that,
and then you
okay,
worship
okay, okay,
only one God.
Okay,
and ask for forgiveness, God forgive
okay,
you.
Okay,
God doesn't forgive
okay,
you.
Okay, let's
that
go.
Is okay. Wrong. What you saying?
Okay, okay.
How
well,
come God is forgive
okay,
you?
Okay,
you're doing another shirk.
Okay, if
and
not,
how come you telling me what
if
surah
I'm
saying?
If
you don't do any other things, God forgive
okay,
me.
Okay, so if it's wrong what I'm saying, then your Quran's wrong, because I'm just simply reading what's on your Quran.
Let me read it.
Up three times, I've read it to you, you don't accept it, that's on you, not me.
No, bring it out, let me read the paper. I have to read it.
One second.
I have to read it.
Because
the sentence is that I'm finished.
Okay, then we can let the audience go away and look this up and they can judge for themselves, okay? So let me just say this, okay? If that's not, okay, if a contradiction isn't really a contradiction there, then what do you do about Surah 2 and Surah 3?
So why you stop there? Why don't you finish it?
Stop
it. Why don't you finish the sentence? The one who said, God forgiving shirk. Why don't you finish?
That's the end of the verse.
No, it's not. You have to carry on reading.
Okay, let's just go to
doesn't
the
say
okay,
that.
Okay.
How come God is going to forgive you? How come Pharisee saying God doesn't give for someone who's making a shirk, doesn't forgive it? And other verses telling God forgive somebody doing shirk.
I'm agreeing with you. You should have a problem with contradictions in your book.
No, I don't.
But you're not admitting it's a contradiction.
No.
Okay, now listen to this.
Is it true Quran doesn't say that?
Okay, one second. Look, okay.
But which Quran is it? Because there's so many Quran is in there.
Okay, look.
Shia book, which one is it?
Stop. This is Quran, okay? Look. Sahih International, okay? The people of the scripture ask you to bring down to them a book from heaven. But they had asked of Moses even greater than that and said, and this is what I've been telling you from my phone, okay? Show us Allah outright. So the thunderbolt struck them for their wrongdoing. Then they took the calf for worship. And after clear evidences had come to them, we pardoned that and gave Moses clear authority. Where does it say any difference to what I've just said?
Okay.
It doesn't.
I know that verse for the Moses, right? When the Moses went to the mountain and bring the Torah, yeah? He bring the Torah to the people and he left his brother behind.
That's not what the
one
verse
minute, that's
about.
The verse. I'm gonna finish the verse because you didn't finish the verse. Because that's you're talking about the Musa, I know, because the people that worship the cow, yeah? You're talking about the Musa, isn't it? The Torah, right? But that's why you read it, right? That's what you read it.
That's from your Quran.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'm from my Quran. That's what you're reading.
Yes, you said Torah. That's
so
Quran.
Quran. Yeah, Quran is everything Torah mentioned in the Quran.
Not quite. Carry on.
Okay, it is.
Not quite.
Because anyway, in the Quran, whatever Moses did, whatever Jesus did, is mentioned in the Quran. Yeah. So Moses went to the mountain. He went to bring the Torah from book from God. God tell him to come and give you some Torah to go and then. Tell you people
okay.
to worship me.
Okay, let me just...
he left his brother behind. When he come back, when he come back, people that worship his cow. Someone called Musa Samarin, he make a cow, yeah? And he got voice. And then he said to the people, Musa went to somewhere else. He lost, yeah? He lost, he doesn't know his God. This is the God that you have to worship. He make the cow for them. And then when the Musas come, yeah, people that worship in the cow. And then he tell his brother, he hold his brother's head. He's saying, why you let these people to do these things? To worship something else. I left it behind. He said, my son of mother, leave my head. Yeah? Because I didn't let them to do this shirk. Because they forced me out. I couldn't do nothing. They're worshiping the cows. Yeah? After Musa telling them, yeah? About the Torah, he bring it. Yeah? More than 60,000 people, yeah? To repent. To repent. How they repented? They have to kill themselves. They killed themselves.
That's in Surah 2, yes.
Couple of thousand, they killed themselves.
So they kill themselves to be forgiven.
1 minute, yeah, forgiven, yeah, because it's...
So, to be forgiven, you have to kill yourself.
That's them time. It's not our time.
And is that a just God?
Yeah, it's them time.
That's a just God.
God can do whatever he wants.
So this is just. God says, kill yourselves, then I'll forgive you.
Yeah,
so the only way to be forgiven is to commit suicide.
Let me tell you. No, that's them time. That's the Musa's time. Yeah, everybody got different times.
So suicide was okay back then?
Let me finish. That's them time. Our time now, you cannot kill yourself. Yeah?
Are you really saying this?
1 minute. Because it's in the Surah saying. You read it, you say? It's in the Surah saying, isn't it?
Yes.
Are you really telling me? One minute.
It's okay to kill yourself.
Brother. That is the damn time. God can change it, anything he wants.
So again, this shows his forgiveness is arbitrary. He will forgive you.
My friend.
He will forgive you, then he won't forgive you, then he will forgive you if you commit suicide.
That is difference because God is bringing every book difference.
I rest my case.
Yeah, every God is bringing different books. Yeah? Torah is different. Yeah, Jesus' book is different. Abraham's book is different. Yeah? Every prophet is a different book they got it. Yeah? So different book, yeah, in Moses' time, they tell them to kill themselves to repent for God. That's the punishment, okay?
Your words
are
mine.
1 minute, yeah, that's what I'm saying. That's what it says in the Quran, okay? And then, in our time now, in the Muhammad time, Whatever you do, if you don't associate any shirk with Allah, God, he will forgive you.
Can I interject now? You spoke for quite a while, okay?
Yeah.
I think maybe we should wrap
this. Does it make sense for you?
Not at all, no. All due respect, all you've done, and I didn't interrupt you then, so let me speak now, okay? All you've done is confirm my belief that the forgiveness of God in the Quran is at its very core arbitrary, incoherent, and contradictory. So you may have thought you was making a case for Islam. You actually made a case against Islam there, okay? You just proved to me that...
No,
I didn't interrupt you. You just proved to me that the forgiveness in Islam is quite frankly a mismatch and not coherent in any sense of the word, okay? Now, I would like to pick you up on something else you said, because we're going nowhere with this contradiction thing. According to you, a contradiction isn't really a contradiction, okay? And suicide to be forgiven is actually okay, so I think we should just drop that at that point. But you also said everything that Jesus done was in the Quran, okay? Now, I would like to challenge you on that, because the Jesus, and let's bear in mind, the earliest accounts of the life of Christ are found in the New Testament, okay? The earliest accounts. When Jesus historians, okay, when you study Jesus as a historian, you don't go to the Quran. It was written 600 years after the fact. You go to the earliest accounts, which are in fact the Gospels and the epistles, okay? And in those epistles and in that Gospel, Jesus said himself in Matthew that he's going to be crucified, okay? And he says in Luke chapter 22, okay, that he will shed his blood for a new covenant. Now, none of that's found in the Quran. So you just said everything Jesus taught was in the Quran. I'm telling you the earliest accounts of Jesus are actually quite contradictory, once again, to the Quran.
That's what you say. Let me answer for you. Yeah?
Face camera, they can't hear.
Okay, let me answer for you. Whatever Jesus says in the Quran, Jesus, he never say, I'm the son of God and worship me.
Ah, but this is your presupposition.
1 minute.
I want you to... I want you to question your presupposition, because you're starting with the viewpoint that the Quran is already correct. I'm asking you to take a step back, take off the Islamic lenses, look at history from an unbiased perspective, okay?
But history because in the Quran, what history are you talking about?
1 second, let's look at Jesus.
Yeah? How do you know the history? How do you know Adam has been created?
If we was to look, okay, at the life of Jesus, yeah? Let's say me and you, I'm not a Christian, you're not a Muslim, we're just two guys studying about Jesus, yeah? Kish, is this still going, yeah?
Yes.
How long's it got left?
2 minutes, 2:50.
Okay, get ready to... So what I'm saying is this, if we're just two guys looking into the life of Jesus, okay, we would look at the earliest accounts, would you agree? You'd have to, okay? There's no point looking at something that comes...
Which book?
1 second, 1 second.
What life is it? 1 second, okay. Okay, there's so many books now.
1 second, okay? Yeah? But we have, as I said earlier, we have to look
Orthodox,
at the...
Orthodox, how many
books? We have to look at the earliest, okay?
How many books are there for the Christian?
My friend, the earliest account of the life of Christ is Matthew, Mark, Luke and John and the New Testament epistles, okay?
So who wrote the New Testament?
Okay, the disciples of Christ.
Who the disciples of Christ? Who wrote it? When is coming?
Okay,
why?
Okay, for example, the Gospel of John, okay? The Gospel of John, if you read chapter 21, it explicitly claims to be written by a disciple, okay? And I don't know if you read John, but in John chapter 21, it says that this is the disciple, okay? The one who was there, the disciple who Jesus loved, it says, okay? It says, this is the disciple who wrote these things down, and we know his testimony is true. Now, why do we know his testimony is true? Because he was, in fact, there, and he wrote those things down.
One second.
If you go to church history, for example, there's a church father called Saint Irenaeus, okay? Now, Saint Irenaeus wrote many works. You can buy his books today. They're still able to be bought, okay? Saint Irenaeus said, okay, that Matthew wrote Matthew, Luke wrote Luke, John wrote John, Mark wrote Mark, okay? Now, who was Irenaeus? Irenaeus was a disciple of Polycarp. Polycarp was a disciple of John. John was a disciple of Jesus Christ. So Irenaeus is only two people away from Jesus Christ, and he confirms that John, the disciple of Jesus, wrote John. How would he know this? He would know it through Polycarp, okay? Polycarp taught him. John taught Polycarp. Polycarp taught Irenaeus. Irenaeus wrote the authorship down, okay? In a similar way, you'd have your hadiths, okay?
Do you believe when I write the book?
Do I believe when you write the book?
Yeah.
Explain that.
Do you believe when I write the book? Because it depends. Depends where you're coming from. Yeah?
I'm not sure you're making a lot of sense.
You said these people are writing a book, right?
Yes.
Yeah, this book, how do you know is it right or wrong?
How do I know whether it's right or wrong? Okay.
Yeah, how do you know it's right or wrong?
Okay. Now let's just take that same standard, okay? I will answer that, okay? But let's say if I just said the same thing to you, how do you know it's right or wrong who wrote the Quran? We could both use that question. It probably doesn't go anywhere. That's why I'm saying to study an individual in history, whether it's Jesus, whether it's Muhammad. If we want to study Muhammad, we should look at the Quran and we should look at the Hadith, because they are the earliest sources of Muhammad. If we want to study Jesus, we have to look at the New Testament epistles and we have to look at the Gospels, okay? I mean, for example, Peter, the disciple of Christ, wrote epistles. He wrote his own writings that are in our books. Okay, he says Jesus was crucified. He says Jesus was God. He knew Jesus.
Okay. Let me tell you, the Quran is the right religion. Let me tell you, the reason I'm telling you the Quran is the right religion, is the right religion, and the right Quran, and coming from the God.
Go ahead, tell me.
Let me tell you the reason. The reason is, no Muslim cannot believe in Jesus Christ. Yeah, no Muslim cannot believe in Jesus Christ. All the Muslims that believe in Jesus Christ as the prophet. If Muslim, he said, I don't believe in Jesus Christ, he's not Muslim.
How does that prove the Quran is right?
It is in the Quran,
does that prove the Quran's true?
It is, because let me finish it, because I'm telling you, because I believe in Jesus.
But let's
all the prophets.
Brother, let's take this argument logically. If you don't believe in Jesus, you're not a Christian, therefore the Bible is true. How does that make sense?
Because if you're a true Christian, as I mentioned in the Quran, you have to worship one God. If you're a fake Christian, if you're a fake Christian and you're telling Jesus the Son of God, that's a fake one.
Okay. Now how do
finish you. Because why? Because Jesus said, I am a prophet. Yeah?
Where?
In the Quran said.
Yeah. Where does that come from? Do you know where that comes from?
It comes from God.
No, hold on. That writing you're quoting, you're quoting the infancy, yes? When Jesus speaks from the cradle and says, I am a prophet of God, yes?
Yeah.
That does say that in the Quran. Jesus says from the cradle, I am a prophet of God, okay?
Yeah.
But your problem is, all due respect, is that that very writing, that very saying of Jesus, is not authentic to the Quran. That's a writing that predates the Quran. That's in an infancy account of Jesus, which is a New Testament apocryphal work, which is too late to be considered authentic, okay? But in the original of that passage, it says, that Jesus is in the cradle and he says, I am the Son of God. Now in the Quran, those words are changed from Son of God to Prophet of God. I would agree with Ibn Hisham, okay? Now Ibn Hisham is a very early biography of Muhammad, okay? And Ibn Hisham says that the Prophet Muhammad, he would sit at the mountain of Marwa, okay? And he would sit with a Christian with resources which the Christian would teach the Prophet, okay? That's in Ibn Hisham's biography. And we know that some Christians in that day would have accepted some New Testament apocrypha, which actual Orthodox Christians do not accept, okay? And it's funny that Muhammad was learning from such a person, and then such writings find their way into the Quran with the message changed slightly. Listen, I'm going to be honest with you. I'm going to let you have the last word. I want you to think about the things I've said.
Okay,
But I want you to think about the things I've said. I've shown you how the salvation in Islam is arbitrary and contradictory. I've shown you how these attributes match up in Christianity in the concept of the cross. It lines up perfectly with the attributes of God. I've shown you now that from the Quran, these verses you're quoting are actually borrowed from other places, okay? And put into the Quran and twisted and changed to suit your prophet's agenda, okay? Now I'm going to leave that there. I want you to go away and think about these things, okay? And I'm going to be here next week.
Okay.
If you have an answer, come back and find me.
I've got an answer now. Simple.
I will let you have the last word now, okay? Because I want to go to the toilet. So
okay.
The
last word is Muslim people. The Quran, all the prophets is mentioned in the Quran. All the prophets. But in Christianity, doesn't mention Muhammad in the Quran. That's what in the Christian books, right? Doesn't mention all prophets. Doesn't mention, right? Yeah. If it's your book doesn't mention all the prophets in your Christian book, doesn't mention all the prophets, that's a fake book. If the Quran is mentioned, all the prophets in the Quran and the belief in Jesus, that's the right one. It's simple.
Thanks for the conversation. Yeah. What's your name?
Yeah, my name is Muhammad.
Muhammad, I'm Ben. Okay. Thanks for your conversation.
Thank you very much.
Thanks for your time. God bless. Take care.